Tonight, the first lecture, you can see the title behind me, Art, Music, and National Identity. We have our speakers. I'll be doing the introduction, followed by the head of school, Dexter Morse, Academy Singers, and then Mr. Bailey on the Jeffersonian ideal of American art. Mr. Plickert, if you could hit the space bar on that. To frame tonight's lecture, I'd like to talk a little bit about this book by Benedict Anderson called Imagined Communities, and there's a nice long subtitle, Reflections on the Origins and Spread of Nationalism. As you can tell by the title, my students will know, right, a well-written essay has a title that indicates the thesis that nationalism is a construct. It isn't as real as we think it is. Next slide, please. And I thought we could demonstrate that by a compare and contrast between Mr. Bailey and me. Mr. Bailey, would you like to come up on the stage with me? Now, according... first of all, we're both about the same height, I think. Willem. We both wear ties to work every day. We both have sons roughly of the same age. We both love coffee. We both read a lot, and we both think writing is the most important thing in education. So it would sound like we have a lot. In fact, we were hired the same year, too, in 97 as full-time employees. So it would sound like we have a lot in common. But if you look through the lens of nationalism, we should be at each other's throats, right? If nationalism is true, and if it's that real and that emotional for both of us, right? I would maintain that we're not that different, and too much of it is imagined and dangerously so. Next slide, please. There are certainly positive aspects of national identity. We seem to need a sense of a collective sense of belonging. And in fact, we've probably evolved that way in groups to begin with. There are other positive features to nationalism. Next slide, please. It fosters cooperation. If you can identify with the other person, and lots of economic historians would argue it's the key to a successful economy as well. Next slide, please. However, pivot of the argument, right? There are the negatives. We can read this from Einstein. Heroism on command, senseless violence, and all the loathsome nonsense that goes by the name of patriotism. How passionately I hate them. And I think we can see what he's driving at, next slide please, is the sort of ultra-nationalism, the dangerous aspects that lead to, very much like last year's lectures, to an us-them mentality. We're so different that we have to hate each other. And that certainly is the downside of national identity. Next slide please. So how do music and art fit into this whole imagined community? That's really the substance of what we're talking about tonight. And a few things, I guess, to be on the lookout for. In terms of the national anthem, I think you'll be surprised by how recent it was adopted. And that might hold a clue about how fragile and how temporary this sense of identity is. There are a few things to look out for in the art presentation, but I think what I'll do is wait until after the Academy Singers and then just interject a couple sentences there. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome the head of school, Dexter Morse, to talk about the story of the National Anthem. Thank you.